Truma, makers of the combi heater and iNet system, are proud to sponsor Practical Caravan TV.
Up a bit. Welcome to Practical Caravan TV, your weekly dose of all things caravanning. Now, later in the show, we'll be looking at a compass rally that's a little bit more practical than this one, and a very funky new model from Knaus. Plus, our Motti will be testing out a mighty new Volkswagen. But first, I've been looking at the Lunar Quasar 574. When Lunar revamped its entry-level Venus brand for 2015, it made life rather difficult for the Quasar. It's the first rung on the Lunar ladder proper, but it's quite hard to justify that nearly £2,000 price difference over a Venus, when the Venus was looking so glamorous. So for 2016, Lunar has given the Quasar a little bit of love. You can tell from that triple front window that this is a rung up from the Venus, and there's also plenty of kit on it. We've got Alco hitch stabiliser, alloy wheels, an external socket in this front locker, not one but three external lockers. And like every range within the Lunar portfolio, Quasar also gains the dead fashionable transverse island bed model, in this case the 574. As always with Lunar, this caravan has been designed with caravanners in mind and how they're going to use it. All of the services are relegated to the offside of the van, so there'll be no wires to trip over in your awning and no cassettes to lug through it. Those updates to the Quasar for 2016 are most noticeable in the lounge here. I mean, this is a particularly attractive finish. I really like this very pale green for the sofas, matched by the curtains, and these rather natty cushions, which look like they've come straight from an interior design shop. It's a four-person lounge, really, makes up into a fairly long but relatively narrow bed. I like the fact there are access doors into the bed boxes on both sides, and they're both pretty clear spaces. We've got the consumer unit under me on one side and the boiler on the other, but actually there's still a good amount of storage space. It feels fairly bright in here as well, and that's despite there being no front sunroof, and that's thanks to the new Skyview roof light, which is a nice thing to have in a sort of lower mid-range van like this. And of course, by not having a front sunroof, you get a load of lockers overhead, so there's plenty of storage. My only slight quibble would be these drawers. It would be nice if they had a slightly smoother action with perhaps soft close, but otherwise this is a really nice place to be. Now, the Quasar may be the first rung on the Lunar ladder, but you're not going to feel shortchanged at all by this kitchen. We've got a dual fuel hob, separate oven and grill, a refrigerator with a removable freezer, and a really good sized stainless steel sink here with a decent amount of worktop next to it. If that's not enough, there's a sideboard on this side with more worktop space, although it is set rather lower. That's because Lunar expect most people to put their TV there. There's a microwave which is set at a really safe height, that's great to see, and there's storage space both above and below, which makes up for the fact that the fridge takes up quite a bit of the space in the kitchen. Alongside the fridge, there's a useful cupboard where you'll also find the table right by the lounge where you're going to need it. It would have been nice to have had a second socket in the kitchen, but otherwise it's hard to quibble. This feels like a particularly well thought out bedroom. The wardrobe over on this side is a little bit on the snug side, but it's more than made up for by the whopper on this side, which has got a drawer and a shoe cupboard beneath. We each get our own reading light and our own shelves, and this rather nice, comfortable, padded headboard. Plus, of course, that window for me to gaze at you through. I really like the fact there's a proper lockable TV stand in here with its own sockets and aerial point. Would you believe that's the third TV point in this caravan? If you're a bit of a Gogglebox watcher, then you're going to be a happy, happy camper in here. Of course, there's more storage to be found underneath this bed. At the moment, it's in day mode, so that gives you plenty of room to get around the foot of the bed. Slide the mattress out, and it makes a 6-foot double. Plus, of course, for whingers like me, there's an extension piece, which costs just £29, and takes it up to well over 6 feet long. Although it is worth pointing out that once it's fully extended, you're going to struggle to get past the foot of the bed to the washroom. And once you've got through the rather awkward sliding door aperture, the washroom is really quite generous. Everything in here is jumbo sized, from the shelf above the frosted window, to the bowl sink, to the cupboard beneath, to the gargantuan shower cubicle, which is fully lined and has a neat moulded shelf. My only complaint is that there's just one blown air outlet for the Truma heating right in the corner, and it'll take a good while to warm up such a big room. Weighing in at 1450 kilos and priced at a shade under 18 grand, the Quasar 574 is aimed directly at the likes of the Bailey Pegasus Brindisi. And they're pretty hard to separate, to be honest with you. I love the way the lounge works in that Bailey, but I'd have to say that the kitchen works slightly better in this Quasar, and it's got a very roomy washroom and shower. In the end, I think you're going to have to go in both and work out which one works better for you.
The front-wheel drive Volkswagen Passat Estate was the overall winner at the Tow Car Awards in 2015. But this car, the Passat Bi-Turbo 4Motion, has more power, a higher curb weight, and the benefit of four-wheel drive. Does that make the Passat 4Motion worth its hefty price premium?
It's certainly a better match for heavy vans than the two-wheel drive car. The 4Motion has a 1,735 kilogram curb weight, which gives an 85% match figure of 1,475 kilos. The legal towing limit is 2.2 tonnes. We match the VW to a Swift Expression 626, with a mass in running order of 1,413 kilograms.
The Passat is very quick indeed. Even towing a big twin-axle Caravan, it took just 7.6 seconds to go from 30 to 60 miles per hour. Steep hills hardly seem to slow the car down at all, and the DSG transmission seamlessly makes the most of all that performance.
The 4Motion is stable as well as fast. In our lane change test, it firmly took charge of the Caravan and was completely unfazed, however hard we drove.
Very few drivers will ever push as hard as we do at the test track. In more normal circumstances, the Passat is unflappable, feeling secure and stable, whatever the weather.
So, the 4Motion is a seriously impressive tow car. It's also a very practical family estate. There's plenty of room for tall drivers up front, and the cabin is well made, and the dashboard logically laid out. There's lots of room in the back of the car too, with enough head and leg room for large adults to be comfortable. However, there is a big transmission tunnel which gets in the way somewhat if there are three passengers in the back. If anything, boot space is even more impressive, with plenty of room for a family's holiday bags. With the rear seats upright, there's 650 litres of space. Lower the back seats and that increases to 1,780 litres.
If you own a mid-sized Caravan, the regular Volkswagen Passat diesel estate is all the tow car you really need. But if you have a heavier Caravan, or you regularly stay on out-of-the-way farm campsites, or perhaps you simply have a heavy right foot, the Volkswagen Passat 4Motion is a superb tow car.
Now, normally when we look at family caravans, we look at price and weight, because most families operate on a budget, certainly younger ones. But what about if you've got a large tow car and an equally large wallet and are looking for a bit of luxury in your family van? Well, how about something like this? It's the Compass Rally 636. It costs more than 25 grand and weighs in at a relatively substantial 1760 kilos, with an optional upgrade to 1900 so that you can haul all your gold with you. Well, it's a pretty good looking van and it's packed with kit. We've got every Alco goodie you could want, with secure receivers for those alloy wheels on the twin axles. There's a gas barbecue point, external access to the lockers, and of course, remote control for the Aldi wet central heating. That's just one of the many things you'll find inside. Now, do you remember those rather heavily tinted windows on the outside? Well, you might expect that to bring a gloomy feel in the lounge here, but in actual fact, that's not the case. We've got a big roof light overhead, we've got a panoramic sunroof at the front, and it's really spacious, so it feels lovely and airy. There's room for six to sit around this lounge area, which is useful because it's a six-berth van, and it'll turn into a massive double bed at night. In fact, if you're not too tall, you could probably use these as singles. If that's not enough for you, however, move slightly forward and you've got a huge dinette. Space here for four to sit around, and at night, unusually, it turns into another double bed. Normally, we'd expect to find a single dinette here with a fold-out bunk above, But the great advantage of this layout is that as your kids grow up into teenagers, they'll continue to be able to come caravanning because the bed is so much wider than those narrow little bunks. Plus, of course, there's space underneath for their bedding and three lockers above to stash all their gear. Now, if you're cooking for six people, you really need a decent kitchen, and this Rally comes up trumps. There's absolutely masses of space in here. We've got loads of worktop here, a little bit more there on the sideboard, a top spec oven, grill and hob, a large sink, although I do find this granite effect a little bit dated, and loads of storage, both above and below. And in this cupboard, you'll find your table to pop in the lounge. Up here, there's a rather natty backlit cocktail cabinet. And overall, you can imagine spending plenty of time cooking here, which is good because this is the kind of van that you're going to put on a seasonal pitch and keep coming back to all year long. One area where this caravan really satisfies one of my obsessions is sockets. We've got two here, kettle, toaster, two up the front, which is perfect for your DVD and your TV instead of just the one, so you'll have to use a multi-plug. And then there's one in the lounge and another tucked away down here for charging your mobile phone. That's just one of the neat touches catering for these bunk users. Often they tend to be a little bit forgotten, but here we've got reading lights, a window each, even a little roof light, and of course a curtain so you can tuck the kids up at night when it's time to retire for a glass of wine. And if that glass of wine is white, well, what better place to chill it than in this simply colossal refrigerator. And above it, there's a microwave, perfectly sited so you're not reaching around up high and pouring hot soup on yourself when you take it out. Now, if we were in a single axle caravan, this bit wouldn't even exist. But the great advantage of a massive twin axle is it just seems to keep on giving. The washroom in this Rally 636 is simply colossal, particularly when you bear in mind the size of the rest of the interior. We've got two bathroom cabinets in here, plenty of room around the loo, and a voluminous shower cubicle. Look at that, it's huge, with an Orbit shower head, some rather natty LED lighting, and a full liner. If I take a little step back, we've even got an enormous wardrobe with not one, but two hanging rails. So there should be plenty of space for all the family to store their clothes. There's a full height mirror here too. It really is something quite special. Now, if you'll give me a moment, nature calls. Compass markets the 636 as a six berth, but I think if you're lucky enough to be able to afford one and there's only two of you or four of you, it works just as well. For a family of four, mum and dad can sleep up front, the kids can have the bunks behind, and there's still this lovely generous dinette area in the middle for breakfast, lunch and tea. And if you're a couple, well, you've got a choice. Double at the front, double in the middle, and when the grandkids come to stay, they've got the bunks. And if you've got extra visitors, well, you've always got this extra two berths in the middle. It's a hugely flexible layout. If you can afford it, it's a really luxurious one too. Now, if you've got around £15,000 to spend on a caravan, you've got plenty of options from the UK manufacturers. But if we're completely honest, they're all pretty much of a muchness, whether you prefer a Venus, a Bailey Pursuit, a Sprite, or an Explore probably depends on your personal preference in terms of interior finish and styling. But what about if you like to be a bit different? Well, perhaps you could have something like this. It's a Knaus Sport and Fun, and it costs a shade under £15,000. We've seen one before, of course, at the NEC last year, but this is the first time I've had a chance to properly get inside and have a proper look at it. And it's a pretty funky thing, isn't it? It looks fantastic. Check out those continental-style bobbly sidewalls, and of course, the door is on the offside, as you would expect from a continental caravan. However, there is something else that's rather more unusual. There is another door. And it's round at the rear here. And it's a particularly wide door with a nice low load lip, which makes it ideal for storing bicycles, canoes, and whatever other paraphernalia you might like to keep in it. Because of course, this caravan is aimed at those younger, active outdoor caravanners that we all hope are coming into the hobby. It's also got a piece of standard equipment that you don't expect to find on an entry-level caravan, and that's an onboard water tank. And if you're thinking, oh goodness, what a pain, it means every time I run out of water, I have to hitch up and tow it to a tap, well, think again, because there's another nice detail here. We simply open up the water tank and unplug this little cover here, and then we can grab our Aquarol, plug in this little portable pump. And start filling it up remotely. As soon as you step aboard, you see the reason why there was so little glazing at the front of this caravan. Because of course, this is where you find the master bedroom. There's a massive double bed here that stretches across the full width of the van, with only a small chunk taken out here at the entranceway. There's plenty of headroom, unless you're tucked right in the front there, when I think that sweeping nose could cause you to bump your head. Above, this isn't an extra bunk, but actually a storage rack, a la British Rail circa 1983. It's quite useful. I've got my coat in here at the moment, but I suspect you don't want to be putting anything too heavy in there. Not only because it might fall on your head, but of course, if you set up too abruptly, you'll give it a bump. One thing that we note, there's only one reading light here, and that could be a bit of a pain for two of you. But if you need more illumination, this van's got a really handy trick. We can just lean into the lounge, nick one of the lights, and place it there. It's such a neat trick and a really useful feature. While we're on the subject of useful features, underneath this bed, you'll find the main storage area in this caravan. Simply take away the headboard, lift up the heavy-duty slatted base, and there's a vast garage which we can access here and also through this large door on the near side and a small one on the offside. Now we've got both doors and all the windows open to try and make it bright in here. It has to be said, natural light wise, it can be a bit dingy, but it's kept lovely and cheery in this lounge by these bright peacock blue fabrics with their contrasting zigzag patterns. And the pale woods look great as well. This lounge has got space for about four people to sit around this neatly chamfered table, which allows access to get past and use the kitchen. At night, of course, the lounge provides another couple of berths. How does that happen, you ask? Well, easy. We pop down the table, remove these side cushions, and grab an infill cushion. Hey presto, an additional double bed. It's not the largest, it's relatively narrow, but it's plenty big enough to have guests over to stay for a couple of nights. And they've even got a couple of lockers overhead to store their gear. Now the first thing to strike you about this lovely curved kitchen area is just how much storage there is. There are cupboards underneath with shelves, huge drawers, more cupboards overhead, but then there's a pretty good reason why we've got so much storage, and traditionalist caravanners won't like this, but there's no oven and there's no grill. All you've got is this admittedly quite spacious three burner hob. And of course, if you want plenty of worktop, you are going to have to keep that glass lid closed because there's not a vast amount without. That said, there's a decent sink, and if we move slightly further back, yet more storage, a load more shelves in here, and this is a natty touch. Up here, the TV point, which is perfectly placed to sit over the lounge for perfect viewing, and there are two sockets in there as well. Across the back of the van, we've got all of the utilities. We've got a really generous refrigerator with a removable freezer compartment and a bottle chiller in the bottom. A simply massive wardrobe, and underneath it, the Truma heater, which has also got blown air ducting that goes all the way to this bathroom, which is roasting hot inside now because we've had the heating on for a few hours, and surprisingly spacious for such a small van. You have to sit kind of side saddle on the loo in there because the space is longitudinal rather than across, but it's pretty spacious and it's pretty well equipped. We've got two little cabinets with a mirror, a little sink, and a nice opaque window to keep things bright in there, because frankly, at the back of the van, without this door open, it is pretty dingy. There's a neat covered socket, but oddly for a well-specified caravan, a shower is optional. One other lovely detail, which I have to point out, is underneath the fridge. It looks like a drawer, but when you pull it out, the whole unit comes out and it's a storage box, or pop it on the ground, grab a cushion from the cupboard, and it's a stool for additional guests. What a great idea. As we've already established, the Sport and Fun is not a caravan for traditional caravanners, But then it isn't really a mainstream model at all. Knaus only expects to sell a handful of them in the UK over the next 12 months. And I suspect for those buyers, buyers who are looking for a compact, stable, stylish and hugely spacious caravan with a flexible interior layout, this is going to be just about perfect, as long as they're not expecting to see another one anytime soon. Don't forget to take your fishing gear with you when you stay on one of Woodhall Country Park's 120 touring pitches. Anglers will be in their element, with a trio of lakes here that guests can drop a line into for a small fee. This attractive Lincolnshire site is set in woodland, not far from the centre of Woodhall Spa. It's open from the beginning of March to the end of November, and in addition to the grass plots, there are 80 fully serviced hard standing pitches for those who prefer low effort caravanning. There are plenty of on-site facilities, but if you fancy getting out and about, you can hire a bike and, once in the saddle, you can pedal the 3-mile traffic-free route along the Spa Trail, or cycle 5 miles to the town of Horncastle.
Also on site we have toilet blocks, fishing lakes. We do things like have family rooms, so if you've got small children, there's one room with a toilet, shower, baby bath, a little chair so you can strap the little one in where you actually get a shower yourself. And we also have a food prep room, which is for those tent campers or the people staying in the pods, where we offer a fridge and a freezer, there's a microwave, there's a grill. And some indoor workspace, basically, if the Great British Weather is living up to its reputation. Yeah, if you're looking for things to do on site, there's an area for dog walking. We also offer some wildlife photography walks to teach you around about what's in the natural area. We also do some little wildlife photography workshops, so teaching you to use all those buttons on your camera that you don't normally do when you just put it to auto and shoot. They'll teach you how to actually capture close-up images of flowers or insects, and that's all part of our sort of philosophy of come and enjoy the rural natural landscape around Lincolnshire. There's a children's playground on site and some football goals. We also have, like say, some woods at the back, so there's plenty of opportunity to go den building and exploring. If camping's not your thing, how about trying a spot of glamping? We offer two types of camping pods. So turn up, unpack, sit down, light the barbecue, and you're straight away enjoying yourself. No hassle of putting a tent up, no hassle of taking one down.
We like to come on this park, this part of Woodhall, because we can do our biking, which we can cycle to Lincoln, Boston, cycling to Horncastle. Anybody can walk without all the traffic all around us.
It might seem as if Adria's 50th anniversary celebrations have been going on forever, but this is perhaps its most significant birthday present to itself so far. It's the 472 DS Eden, and it's based on the entry-level Altea range. Now you can tell from those silver front and rear panels and side skirts that it's something a bit different, but it's more than just a paint job. If you look closely, it's got a huge front panoramic sunroof, a standard AKS hitch stabiliser and standard alloy wheels. There are other things that I particularly like about it though. Check out that enormous locker, giving you plenty of access to the underbunk space. I like the fact that all of the surfaces, except for these fridge vents, are relegated to the other side of the van. If you look closely, you can tell it's based on an entry-level model with things like this windowless door. But when you get the other side of that door, which we better do soon because I think it's about to rain, you'll find it doesn't feel like a cheap caravan at all. Well, this is the perfect place to enjoy that massive panoramic front sunroof. It really is huge. It's almost like the whole ceiling is taken up by glass. It does make it beautifully light in here, and it's not the best of days, but it does feel lovely and bright. This front lounge is probably the larger of the two, and it's extremely comfortable. There's space around this table for about 5 people. The table itself is somewhat low set, to be honest. However, one great thing, it's stored just here at the front of the kitchen, so it's perfectly placed to grab it when you need it. The seats themselves are pretty comfortable and they combine to make a large double bed at night. And up front here, you haven't got the traditional front chest. Instead, there's space for an extra person and a little flip-up table for when you need it. This single front window is rather smaller than you would get in a lot of modern caravans, but you don't really notice that because of that great overhead sunroof. And one thing I really love about this van is this subtle lighting beneath the cabinets and the cabinets themselves. Notice there's no catches. It's such a clean, modern, uncluttered design. They're hidden out the way, and when you open them up, there's light already there. From one lounge to another here at the back. This is the ideal place to relegate your kids to, which is a nice luxury to have in what is a relatively compact caravan. Another nice luxury to have is simply vast amounts of storage space. Obviously, we've got the two bed boxes underneath each side and five overhead lockers above. It's hugely spacious. It's pretty spacious to sit around as well. You could definitely get six kids in here to play a board game, probably only about four adults. There's further storage to be found in a nice little unit hidden away here to one side, which has got three deep drawers. And above it, well, here's where you mount your TV, so you can watch it from the front or the back here. And of course, you'll find all the necessary sockets there. At night time, unfortunately, none of the sofas in this caravan are quite long enough to be used as single beds, unless your kids are particularly tiny. However, like the front, underneath the bed boxes, there are pull-out sections that make it turn into a good-sized double bed. And usefully, there's a fifth berth here in a fold-out bunk behind me. Now, the Eden is based on the budget Altea range, so you might expect kitchen equipment to be a little bit meagre. That's not the case, though. We've got the classic Adria three-burner stove, which drains straight into the stainless steel sink. Always a nice touch. One thing we haven't got very much of is worktop, however, unless you've got that lid closed, and then there's a decent amount of preparation space. Beneath it, we've got a good-sized refrigerator and a combined oven and grill. And up above, hidden in this cupboard rather neatly, there's even a microwave oven. What we don't have, however, is very much storage. There's a couple of shelves here, and there's a pan drawer down here underneath the oven, but that seems to be about it. So you've got to go on a hunt. Obviously, there's all those lockers at the back of the van that we saw earlier. And just here, well, this is where you're supposed to put your crockery and your mugs. And over on this side of the van, there's a drawer, and inside it, there's your cutlery drawer. So things are moved around the van a little bit, but it's all there. Above this cutlery drawer, there's a very good sized wardrobe, which also houses the electricity consumer unit. You'll also find a single socket and all of the main controls in here, while the controls for the Truma heater are in the lounge. There was never going to be a palatial washroom in this van, but the compact wet room still comes as quite a surprise for a family caravan. That said, it packs quite a lot into its compact dimensions. There's a proper shower on a proper riser bar, and it's fully lined, although the wheel arch does intrude somewhat into the floor space. There's a blown air outlet, a bench toilet, and a natty drop-down sink, with a large bathroom cabinet above. There's even a shower curtain and a frosted window. The Eden's twin lounge layout may be nothing new, but it's a long overdue addition to the Adria range, and it's likely to broaden the appeal of the Altea line, which at the moment tends to cater for people with larger tow cars. Weighing at 1,350 kilos laden, this van is open to a much broader variety of cars. It also looks fantastic and boasts an impressive specification for its price, which is less than 15.5 grand. We're pretty convinced that from next year, it'll be offered as a standard model, and chances are that price might get even keener, which makes it even more appealing. Well, that's all we've got time for this week, but don't worry, we'll be back very soon with more great reviews, tow cars, and brilliant places to stay. Next time, we'll be taking a look at a special edition Luna and testing the super funky Skoda Yeti Outdoor. In the meantime, you can keep up with us on Facebook or via our website, and don't forget that Practical Motorhome TV follows in just a few minutes. Till next time, bye-bye.
Truma, makers of the combi heater and iNet system, are proud to sponsor Practical Caravan TV.